This video was made possible by Wix. If you're ready to create a website, head on over to wix.com/go/infographics2019 to try out one of their premium plans right now. Right now, the Earth is 149,597,870.696 kilometers away from the Sun, but let's round that number to about 93 million miles. But did you know that our dear blue planet is actually on the move? And that distance is growing larger and larger all the time. This is because of the loss of mass of the Sun due to radiation. But don't worry, we won't be drifting away from the Sun anytime soon. On January 3, 2019, the Earth was at its closest distance of the year to the Sun, which is known as the perihelion. This year at its perihelion, Earth was about 1.5 centimeters farther away than it was last year, which is a little further than the year before, and the year before that, and on and on. So while we are moving further away from the Sun all the time, it's by an incredibly small amount. Like we said, nothing you need to worry about. Yet. Right now, we're in the perfect position to not be too hot or too cold, a Goldilocks zone if you will. But even a relatively small change in the Earth's orbit would be a disaster, small on the scale of the solar system that is. According to the researchers at the Sorbonne University, if Earth was just a fraction farther away, it wouldn't even look like the Earth as we know it. It would be inhospitable, and we'd all soon perish. If we moved closer to the Sun, the glaciers would melt, raising the sea level and flooding the Earth. If it went the other way and we moved a bit further from the Sun, CO2 would condense at the poles, making a lot of ice. The planet would not be able to warm up, leading to a permanent ice age. It would be hell, a very, very cold version of hell. According to another writer, in either situation, life on the surface of the planet would mostly die, including us. But life under the ground or deep down in the ocean might survive. The problem, though, is that gradually the Earth's core will cool, slowing the rotation of the core. This will lead to the loss of our magnetic field, which protects us from the Sun's solar wind. Once the magnetic field is gone, solar winds will be free to strip our atmosphere away. Earth will become a very barren place and look much like Mercury or Mars. Speaking of other planets, let's look at how far away they are from the Sun, since if we know that, we might better understand what Earth might look like if it was very far away. As you know, the planet closest to the Sun is Mercury, at 36 million miles away. Next is Venus at 67.2 million miles, and we are of course the third rock from the Sun. You already know that distance, hint it's 93 million miles. After us comes Mars at 141.6 million miles, where life would hardly be any fun at all. Weather readers there would give pretty miserable forecasts. According to NASA, during winter on Mars, you might have a high of 2 degrees Fahrenheit, but the temperature might drop to around minus 138. Then there's all that dust and those famous Martian winds. Life on Mars is no walk in the park to say the least, which is why Elon Musk plans to live in a habitat. Hope you're fine with never going outside without a protective suit on again. Jupiter is the next planet on the list at 483.6 million miles from the Sun, and after that comes Saturn at 886.7 million miles. Then we have the planet that is literally the butt of planet jokes, Uranus. Poor picked on Uranus is 1.784 billion miles away from the Sun. So a billion miles away from the Sun is somewhere between Saturn and Uranus. Let's now see what life is like on Saturn. If you thought life on Mars was tough, Saturn is much harder. Even Matt Damon and his potatoes wouldn't stand a chance. Universe Today writes that it's hard to imagine a planet less hospitable for life than Saturn. The planet is comprised almost entirely of hydrogen and helium, with only trace amounts of water ice in its lower cloud deck. Temperatures at the top of the clouds can dip down to negative 150 degrees Celsius. The lack of a rocky core is why we refer to these types of huge planets as gas giants. The planet does not support life, so don't even think about moving there. It is beautiful, at least, with its incredible rings around it, which are made of chunks of rock and ice. If you look at Uranus, its atmosphere is made up of hydrogen and helium. It's a ball of ice and gas, and as one scientist put it, if we tried to land a spacecraft on it, we'd end up sinking into its liquid icy center, which wouldn't be any fun at all because, as NASA says, that core has a temperature of 9,000 degrees Fahrenheit, which may sound high but is actually fairly low compared to other planets, like Jupiter, where the core is a whopping 43,000 degrees Fahrenheit. But we wouldn't get that far anyway, as the pressure would squish the spacecraft long before we made it to the core. And the top of the atmosphere is no better, with temperatures around negative 370 degrees Fahrenheit. On top of that, you have wind speeds of 560 miles per hour. The days are short, at 17 hours, but the years are another matter, because 1 year on Uranus is 84 Earth years. But going back to Saturn, scientists think that some of the moons there may support life, such as Titan, which, like Earth, has an atmosphere, and is probably the most Earth-like body, which is around 1 billion miles from the Sun. It also has rain, oceans, lakes, and what one writer described as vicious storms. The major differences are, well, there are many, but the biggest factor is that its atmosphere is 98% nitrogen and 2% methane, unlike the Earth, which is around 78% nitrogen and 20% oxygen, with gases like carbon dioxide and argon making up the rest. So it's Earth-like, but as one scientist called it, a deranged version. Another scientist said about Titan, "The essential chemical building blocks for life are present in the atmosphere, but Titan's surface is quite inhospitable to life as we know it because of its extremely low temperature and the absence of liquid water." And he wasn't kidding about the low temperature. It gets very chilly there. According to NASA, the average temperature on Titan is negative 290 degrees Fahrenheit. It also only gets around 1% of the total sunlight we get here on Earth. There are very long periods of darkness, and if your boss tells you that you'll get a pay raise next year, you might not feel so glad, since it takes Saturn and its moon Titan 29 Earth years to go around the Sun. And these are the conditions the Earth would basically experience if it were also that far from the Sun. Beyond frigid temperatures, little light, probably no magnetic field, and definitely no life. We can only guess at what it would be like if the Earth moved 1 billion miles away from the Sun, but needless to say, anything 1 billion miles from the Sun is pretty much inhospitable. Even if we were just a fraction further away, things would get nasty very quickly. Never mind 1 billion miles. We are in the perfect place, and we should be grateful for our privileged position in the solar system. But let's say you need a website, and you don't have an entire Saturn-length year to get it done. What are you gonna do? Well, we've got just the solution for you. Wix. With Wix, you can get an incredible-looking website up and running in no time. Their powerful ADI feature can help you build a site in just minutes, simply by answering a few questions. Or you can use their intuitive drag-and-drop interface on hundreds of fully customizable templates to get the exact style you're looking for. No matter which way you choose, Wix's subscription service offers 24/7 tech support, and an extensive knowledge base is always available to help you tackle any problems. So don't wait any longer. Go build that site you've been thinking about right now with Wix by visiting the link in the description or going to wix.com/go/infographics2019. How do you think we'd survive if the planet was moved 1 billion miles away from the Sun? Would it even be possible? Tell us what you think in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other episode, What Would Happen to Your Body in Space? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.